So today we'll focus on creating our own vector data. This has many applications, such as digitizing collected field data, creating custom geographies, or delineating relevant features and attributes when a dataset does not already exist. These procedures give you control over the extent and content of features while enabling information and geometries from other layers to be integrated. We'll explore these procedures by creating a polygon vector, delineating three features, and providing some simple attributes. So the first step is to load the census division file into the layers panel, and then we'll enable three additional toolbars by right-clicking on an empty space within the toolbar area or on a panel title and selecting them from the drop-down. Specifically, we'll enable the advanced digitizing, shape digitizing, and snapping toolbars. We can reposition and detach these toolbars from the interface as desired. To create our new dataset, we can go to the layer drop-down on the menu bar, select Create New Layer and New Shapefile Layer. This opens a box where we can begin to parameterize our new dataset. And the first thing we need to do is provide an output directory and file name, clicking on the triple dot icon. We'll store it in our intro demo folder along with our two boundary files, and we'll call our file AOI, short for Area of Interest. Next thing we'll do is we'll expand the geometry dropdown and select the desired geometry, in this case polygon. And then we'll alter the projection away from the default WGS84 to a projected coordinate system, specifically UTM zone 14. So we'll click on this icon to open the coordinate system selector, in which we can use the specific name of a system of interest to isolate it. I just want to highlight that the results are divided by geographic and projected coordinate systems. If we select a system of interest, it shows us the extent of its coverage in the bottom right corner. So now let's search for the one of our interest, in this case UTM zone 14. Scrolling down to the bottom of the results, we can see that there's 14N and S. Since we are in the northern hemisphere, we would like 14N. We could have also used the EPSG code to isolate our system of interest, in this case 32614, clicking OK. So now that we've defined the spatial characteristics of our data set, we can also add some fields to our attribute table. The first we'll add is a comments field, and we'll leave it as a text field type, providing it with a length of 100 characters, meaning that up to 100 characters can be stored for each feature within the field. Then we'll add a second field, a decimal number type, and we'll call it area ha, short for area in hectares, using a length of 12 and precision of 2. In this case, length refers to the number of characters before a decimal place, and the precision refers to the number after. So with our dataset parameterized, we can now click OK. So the dataset's listed within our layers panel and the browser panel, but not visible in the canvas since we haven't delineated any features yet. So let's enable our editor and create our first feature. We'll use the Add Polygon Feature tool. This is the most common tool for adding features of any geometry type, and for our polygon, delineating any shape, regular or irregular. We'll also enable the Advanced Digitizing panel and the Snapping toolbar. By default, the Advanced Digitizing panel will snap our lines at 90 degree angles, and the Snapping toolbar can be used to snap to vector data sets, specifying the layers to snap to in the first dropdown, whether it's just the active layer or all layers, the specific components of the data set to snap to, and the distance over which it should occur. So scrolling in, the first feature we'll delineate is around the census division for Winnipeg. So to delineate our feature, we can left-click to add individual vertices to our data set, and once we're satisfied with the extent, we can right-click to complete our feature. This opens the feature attribute box, which enables us to populate our attributes while delineating. Since it's our first feature, we'll apply an ID of 1, and we'll give it a distinct name in the comments field, calling it Add Polygon Feature, and clicking OK. So now it's visualized as shown within the layers panel. Now we'll just toggle off our advanced digitizing and snapping toolbar, and we will next use the shape toolbar to add our next feature. So this contains various tools for adding regular polygons to our data set, and the one that we'll use is add rectangle from center and point. So we can click where we want the center of our polygon to be, and then expand outwards and right click to complete our feature. Since our second feature, we'll give it an ID of 2 and provide it with a name, in this case, shape digitizing feature. Additional tools on the advanced digitizing toolbar can be explored on your own. The final means for adding a feature I'd like to discuss today is copying the geometries from another layer. So we'll just toggle our AOI layer off and select the census division layer and use our interactive selection tools to select the divisions around Winnipeg. Then we can click on the copy icon on the digitizing toolbar, re-enable our AOI layer, and click paste. So 8 features were successfully pasted. We could leave these features as separate features, but in this case, I'd like to use the merge tool to combine them into one. So as you can see, the entries are null for all of our pasted features since the fields do not match those within our AOI layer. So we can just click on skip all fields and OK. And now you can see it's been merged into one single feature. Since editor is still enabled, we can open the attribute table and provide its attributes, an ID of 3, and we'll call it merged CDs, short for census divisions, numbers 2 and 3, and 9 through 14 around Winnipeg. So with our feature delineated and the attributes provided, we can now save our edits and toggle the editor off. Well done. We have now successfully created our own dataset, delineated some custom geographies, and populated their attributes. Specifically, we learned how to parameterize our vector layer, delineate features with the available toolbars, paste and merge geometries from other layers. These procedures can be used to delineate line and point datasets and also extend to editing the geometry of downloaded vector data. In the next demo, we'll explore attribute-based selection tools to help isolate features by criteria of interest.